had discussed a static control flow and non-static control flow. So two members are there in the CoreJava. One is the static member, one is the non-static member. So in the static member, we have some members like a static variable and a static block, main method and a static method. So there are four members in the static member in the CoreJava. And non-static member, we have also the four members. So we have a non-static variable, non-static block, constructor, and non-static method. So these are the members of a static and non-static. So, but in the previous session, we had discussed how the they are executing in the orders. Okay, if you in one class we have a I have a static variable, a static block, main method, and a static method. So how they are executing? So just I will give you the little bit review regarding this. So what will happen? Same thing happened when some class is loaded. Then JVM identify non-static variable, non-static block, non-static method, and main method from superclass to subclass. They are defining in the top to bottom, right? After that, second steps, what will happen? JVM will execute a static variable, a static block from superclass to subclass in the order they are defined. So why we have mentioned in the order they are defined? So if you will create the static block first, then first the static block will be executed. Okay? If you will declare a static variable first, then a static variable will be executed. But both are depend upon what happened. Okay, I'll share my screen. Just I am revising this stuff. Okay, so don't worry about that. So after that, what will happen? This is the static. This is the how it is working. Then after variable, a static variable and a static block. Then main method is executing. Okay, after main method is executing, current class main method will be executed. If your main method having in the subclass, then subclass main method will be executed. If your current class having in the main method in the superclass, then superclass main method will be executed. If main method is not available, then JVM will throw the exception, runtime exception. Finally, your static method will be executed. So this is the flow of non-static block, right? Will come in the static members. So we'll come in the non-static member, same like that a static. There are four member in the static block. Okay, first is the non-static variable, non-static block, constructor, and non-static method. So same thing, execution is same like non-static. Then what will happen? You can see here, first JVM will, when subclass is loaded, JVM will identify superclass from subclass. First it will identify a non-static variable, non-static block from superclass to subclass in the order they are defined. After that it will execute non-static variable, non-static block from superclass to subclass in the order they are defined top to bottom. In the order means if you will having a non-static block first, then non-static block will be executed. If you having a non-static variable first, then non-static variable will be executed. After that, constructor is executing. After that, your non-static method will be executing. So this example I had given in the last session, but today example we'll discuss the static and non-static both. So in this we have one more example. Wait one second. So that example having the static and non-static member both. Okay, so how both, if you having the static and non-static member, how it will execute? Okay, so what will happen? First it will execute a static member, all the static member it will execute first. Okay, it will execute all the static member first. Okay, I think this is the same example of is just an example. So you can see here, just I will explain a little bit. This is the non-static, a static variable, right? This is the static variable. How it is a static variable, right? In the last session I had discussed. This method I have created here, and this method M1 I declare in the A variable. So just why I am doing this, because you guys able to understand how this control flow is working. Okay, so this is the non-static variable, and this is a static variable. This is the non-static variable. Okay, and now we have a static block, a static block. You can see, static block. We have a non-static block, yeah, so go ahead. Having any doubt, Ashok? You having any doubt? Yeah. Now you are not able to see my screen. Oh, sorry. I forget. Now able to see. Okay. Sorry for that. Actually, I did not click on the shares. Okay, so again I will explain this system. So this is the static variable. Okay, this is the static variable. So why I am doing this? I have created one M1 method, and this is the int type, and M1 method I am declaring this here, initializing this. Why? Because you guys able to see how this execution flow is working. So in this example, we having a static block, a static member and non-static member both. So we will see how both it working, static and non-static. So just we'll explain this. Same thing is there in the previous session what I had discussed, but here the static and non-static in one shot is there. So you guys, I think, able to understand. Okay, no problem. Okay. So this is the non-static variable, and this is the a static variable, and this is the non-static variable, and this is the static block again, and this is the non-static block, and this is the constructor. Okay, this is constructor. So constructor I will discuss in the coming class, but how to know this is the constructor. Constructor name and class name is same. Okay, so this is called constructor. So what is the constructor, what is the use of constructor, later session I will discuss. This is the static method, okay, and this is the non-static method, this is the static method, this is the non-static method. So you can see this is the super class and subclass. We have did same step. This is the static variable. Okay, and I did same step, right? I took int type of C variable, I initialized this M1. Okay, and this is the non-static variable, static var. Okay, and this is again I took a static block. This is the subclass static block. Okay, and you can see here, this is the again non-static block, and again this is the constructor. You can see this constructor name and class name is same. So this is constructor. Okay, in the previous session we had discussed how the static control flow is working, how non-static control flow is working. We having the separate example before we had discussed, but in this session I'm going to show you the static and non-static member in the one example. So how both are executing. So this is the constructor. You can see this is the main method is there, and just we are calling this two methods here. Okay, you can see, you can observe one. See, in the last session I had discussed, before calling it won't be executed, right? But this is the concrete method, non-static method and a static method m3 and m4. You can see I called this method, right? I called this method, a static method you can call directly or you can call by object also, no problem at all. But you can see I have created this method m1 and I have created this method m2 and I have also created this method m5, m6, but we are not executing this method, we are not calling, but still output is coming because of this execution flow. Why the output is coming without calling? Because I have initialized this variable, okay? I have initialized this m1 method on this variable. So what will happen? Control will come and this execute this line. If this line will be executed, this method is executed. Okay, so in the interview, one question is there, how you will call the method without calling? How you will execute the method without calling? So this concept you have to tell, yeah, if you will go in the control flow, we have a concept of the static variable. So a static variable will be executed according to the top to bottom in the order they are defined. So what we can you have to explain, what if any method will be created, then that method I will initialize with this static variable. So without calling this method, it will be executed. Okay, so now we'll execute this. Now able to compile this and now able to run this. So you can see how this output is coming. Okay, I will explain this output because this output is important. Okay, so you can see here, this is called a static variable example. Example is the super class. So first, a static member will be executed. Okay, again you can see a static block example is executing. Again, a static variable simple is executing. Simple is a subclass. A static block simple again executing, subclass. After that, main method is executing. So these are the member of a static. So according to the order, they are executing, right? Now it comes non-static example is executing. Again, non-static block is executing. Again, what it will execute? Constructor will be executed. Non-static variable will be executed. Non-static variable simple. This is the super class. Non-static member are executing, three members, and subclass, three members are executing. But you can see the method, concrete method will be always execute after variable, block, and main method and constructor. You can see here this static method is executing after executing all the members. All the members means first a static variable will be executed, a static block will be executed, a static variable will be executed, a static block, super class, subclass. Again you can see main method is executing. So static is over. Again what will happen? Non-static variable is executing, non-static block is executing, constructor is executing. This is the super class is over, then subclass non-static variable is executing, non-static block are executing. After that, in the last, my computer is hanging. Okay, so in the last, a static method is executing, then non-static method is executing, then concrete method is always executing in the last. Okay, these are the very important example for practice on your system. And what you have to do, just you know, do like yourself also, after understanding this code, make yourself a static or non-static, change the order and execute it. Okay, do you have any question regarding this example? I think two people did not join today. Can I go ahead? You have any doubt regarding this example? I will explain once if you having any doubt. This is very important. Can I go ahead? Yeah, tell me. Yes. This one. Okay. In the method we had discussed, no, return type. So you can see here type is int, here type is int, understood, right? So why we are using this return statement? By using this return statement, JVM is able to understand. So you can give the any value. If you are using any type, no, here, then you have to use this return statement. Why we are returning this value? Because the JVM is able to understand this type is int. You can return any value. If you will return 0, it will also work. Understood, right? We are telling to the JVM this type is n. Sorry, int type. Understood? So, understood? So, are you able to understand what I had discussed? Still you have a doubt? Okay, so what you have to do, go in the method topic and just return type is topic is there, go through that. Okay, I will explain once. If you can give any type, a string type, float type, right? So if you will not give this return keyword here, then JVM is not able to understand which type you are giving. So that's why CoreJava have given one keyword that is called return keyword, and you can return whatever the type you are providing. If you are providing the string type, then you have to return the string type. If you are providing the float type, you have to return the float type. But your question is why we are doing it? Because the JVM is able to understand this is a type. Understood, right? Regarding control flow, do you have any doubt how the all the things is working? Just go through the previous session and previous example, work on it. Still you have any doubt, you can ask him in the coming session. Okay. So in the previous session we had already discussed, but just I am giving this theory regarding this non-static member. So what members are called non-static member, class level member which does not have a static keyword in its creation statement are called a non-static members. Okay, so there are, you know, types of the static members. So there are four types of the static members, sorry, non-static member. We have already discussed this. So non-static variable, non-static block, non-static method and constructor. Okay. So when do all the above member get memory location and by whom? Okay, so you know that non-static member, we have to create an object, right? If you will not create an object, what will happen? If I did not create this object here, so what will happen? Non-static member will not execute. If I will compile this code, if I will not create an object, non-static member will not get executed. Why it is not executing? Because the non-static member, when you will create an object, non-static member will get memory. Okay, so that's why I have mentioned here object is this one, all the above member get memory only if object is created with the new keyword and constructor, or that class will JVM not provide memory location by this member by default. Means when class is loading, so at that time only a static member is getting the memory. Non-static member are not getting the memory, okay? What is an object and creation syntax, okay? So object is of an instance. Instance is a technical language of the CoreJava. Okay, instance of an object that contains memory location of all non-static variables of all, yeah, you can tell all the non-static member of the class with the specific data of this instance. Okay. So object creation created by the new keyword and constructor of the dat class. So this is the syntax of the object creation. So we have a accessibility mode, access modifier, you can tell accessibility modifier, class name, variable name, new keyword, and this class name again, and this part is called constructor. So accessibility modifier, there are four types of the accessibility modifier: public, protected, private, default. So here I have used this public access modifiers. Here I use this static class name. I use here simple one. Variable name I use here s, and new keyword is there. I use this new keyword, and this is the constructor name. Constructor name, you can say the class name or constructor name is same, but this brackets we have to give here, so it will become the constructor. Okay, so just example, I have given this, you know, this object creation. So you can see here, this is public statics. These are the depend upon your requirement. If you have in the requirement in the, sometime they are using this stuff. But again, I have given this example of this above statement or creation test class object. This class test, I have created this object. So what is the value of, what is the meaning of this? New test is actually a statement for the object creation. What will happen if you are creating an creating the new test? Then one, so new means what will happen? One object is created. If anything is creating, then you have to initialize, right? The work of the new, this the job of this new means, it is creating an object. It is creating an object. But if you are creating something, then you have to initialize. If you are creating an object, then you have to initialize also. That's why we are using this constructor. This constructor. This is called constructor. The job of new means it is created an object, and the job of constructor means it is, you know, initializing an object. So actually the statement for the object creation, these statement allocates memory for the all non-static member of a class. Okay, the statement t dot test dot t will only create a variables with the same t that store the object. What will happen? This new is created an object, and this constructor is initialized an object. Then what you have to do? You have to hold on this object, right? So I can give you one example. If you are making the home, right, then you have to, home is without pillar, how you will make the home? So first the home is there, then the pillar is also there. This the reference variable is the pillar. Okay, and now why we are giving this? Because of, I have to tell to the JVM, this is the test class type of an object. This is the type, which type of an object. So this is the test type of an object. Okay, so its t is called reference variable because it's store the reference variable, because it's store the reference of an object. Okay, so we have already discussed this stuff. So some steps involved, again I had discussed about of this technically on how they are, you know, working on it. So steps involved in the object creation. So in object creation, we have a four steps. One is the declaration, instantiations, and initialization and assignment. So someone will ask, can you explain this? What is this? So first part is called declaration. This. Okay. Second part is called instantiations. This is called, these are the technical language. Okay. These are the technical language. And third part is called initialization. Okay, and fourth part is called this fourth, this reference variable is called assignment. So this thing I have declared in declaration, reference variable e1 is memory created, m1 memory created. What is the meaning of instantiation? Object memory get allocated in that memory non-static variable of example. Class memory is created with default value based on your data type. Whatever I had discussed the previous, just I am exploring this, that's it. Initialization means value are stored in the object of non-static variable. An assignment means object reference ID is stored in the reference variable. So these are the, you know, explanation of this. But you can simply tell for why, what is the use of this new keyword, what is the use of this constructor, and why we are using this reference variable, and why we are using this. So you can explain in your language, in your technical, yeah, whatever. Okay, just you have to tell the correct thing. What is the use of all the fourth part? Okay. So these are the objects. So responsibility of new keyword and constructor. I have already discussed it, right? So new keyword has the three responsibility: object memory creation with non-static variable available in class with their default values. Invoking the constructor for the initialization. Same stuff what I had discussed. Referring this object reference. So this keyword I will come in this coming session. I will discuss this. Actually, what will happen? By default, if you are, if you are creating any non-static member, so by default this keyword is there. By default, this keyword is added by the compiler. So coming session, I will show you. I will give you the example of this keyword and why we are using this keyword. In the coming session, I will discuss this keyword. Okay. So these are the, this constructor is responsibility only for initializing an object with assigned value and further using this given value. Okay, these are the non-use thing. I'm not explaining this. Okay. You know the main method we had discussed, and I have given the theory also. Just I have given some point of the main method. So main method is a predefined method. It is a mediator between Java programmer and JVM. Who is the Java programmer? In the first session I had discussed, right? What is the job of the main method? If you are not giving the main method, then our JVM, Java Virtual Machine, will not interact with users. Who is the users? They are the users, your developer. Okay, who is writing the code? So what will happen? The JVM, in this example I have given, in the first demo class, I think. What is the job of the main method? What happened? What is the job of main method here? The job of the main method here, if you will not give the main method, then what will happen? We are able to compile this and we are able to run this, right? We are not able to run because the JVM is looking for the main method. Main method is not found in the demo test. Please define the main method. But why this error is coming? Okay, your question is why this error is coming. Okay, now I have created one method here. Okay, I have created one method here, M1. Okay, now I want to call this method, then how we will call this, right? If I want to call this method, okay, so can I able to call this? If I will compile this, you can see I am able to compile, but I am not able to run this. Again, JVM is asking, please define the main method. What will happen? If you are writing any code as a class level, yeah, anywhere, if you are writing as a code, then what will happen? We have to interact with Java Virtual Machine. So the people who develop the core Java, they have given the common method. If you will common method, yani main method will be executed. So while executing the main method, your all logic will be executed. Okay. So what is the job of the main method? The job of the main method, they are interacting with user and Java Virtual Machine. Means we are the users. And we are interacting with this, JVM and this users, yeah, programmers. We are the programmer, we are the users. Okay, what you can tell. So what will happen? Now, we have to create an object because this is the, I will not make non-static. I am making this a static here. So if you will call now here, a static you can call directly, right? So now what will happen? We are the users, user is interacted with this main method. Now if the main method is there, then this method, main method is executing. Inside this main method, I call this M1 method. So now we are able to print this. This is the job of the main method. Okay, someone will ask why we are using this main method. So your answer is here. Okay, so it interact with the syntax between the JVM and the Java programmer. Without main method we can't run, you know, execute the stand alone program, but we can compile. You can compile, but you are not able to run this. Okay, so you are not able to run this. So reference type conversion. Okay, so reference type conversion, what is the reference type conversion? You know, the reference type conversion means we are doing casting here. What is the casting? Conversation means just we are, you know, converting one type to another type. Okay, we have to convert like int type to float type. We have to convert, you know, object class to you know, user defined class. So that's why we are using this reference type conversion. We having some theory, but I will come in this example, then you are able to understand this reference type conversion. So like primitive types, we can also perform type conversion. Like primitive type means in float double operation in between the reference type conversion. Reference type conversion means class type. Primitive type, you know, I had to discuss, you know, reference variable and primitive variable, right? Reference variable means the reference variable means class type of the reference variable, and primitive type means just simply int a equal to 10. This is the primitive type. So we having a, you know, like operation, like, you know, type conversion. So assigning the one class object to another class reference variable, this is called reference type conversion. Okay, one type object to the another class means one type, we are doing the conversation one type to another type, that is called the reference type conversion. Type, to perform reference type conversion, the two classes should be compatible. Okay, when you are performing reference type conversion, there should be a two type classes should be there, otherwise you are not able to do. Conversion means one class to another class, right? So you having the only one class, then how you will do the conversion, right? So it is mandatory you having the two class, right? Two classes. Two classes means we will achieve, classes are the compatible only if they develop with the inheritance, EJ relationship, right? We will develop as an EJ relationship, inheritance concept. The classes created without inheritance relation are called siblings. I will come in session, I will tell you what is the meaning of the siblings. If you are using this class, okay, this is the class, I created one more class. Okay, but I did not perform any inheritance concept, right? So this class is called siblings, okay. This class is called siblings. If you will perform this inheritance, okay, this is called EJ relationship. Yeah, you can tell inheritance, okay. This is called EJ relationship and you can call inheritance. But you are not performing this extend keyword. If you are not performing this extend keyword, then what will happen? These classes are called, these classes are called sibling classes. Okay, so this thing I have mentioned here, the classes created without inheritance relation is called siblings. The classes are compatible only if they are developed with inheritance concept. Okay, so if the superclass reference variable holds the subclass object, then on that variable we can call only overridden object method. So I will come in this overriding concept, but I will explain this code, you guys able to understand. Just I will come again this theory. Okay, now you are not able to understand 100% here. Okay, if the superclass reference variable hold the subclass object, then on that variables we can call only overridden method of the superclass in subclass, and those method which are available in the superclass, but we cannot call the specified method of the subclass. You know, in the previous session, I have given one example, right? The concept of overriding. But just I will tell you, but I am not relating this casting a stuff with this concept, but little bit I will tell you what I want to tell you, what I want to discuss here. What happened in the last session, I have given this example of overriding concept. So how to achieve this overriding? We have a one method called void m2. Okay, this method I have void m2 here, and I have created this method void m2. Okay, this m2 is m2 superclass. Okay, again I have created one more object in the subclass. I have to create an object, right? A class again. So demo test. Okay, now I have created this is the super class, this is the subclass. Again you can see both method name is same. I have created both method in the super class and subclass, just I have given the different implementation here. This is the super, just I am making this is the sub. Okay, now what we have to do, if I will create an object of this subclass, if I will create an object of this subclass, I have to save this class, okay? Otherwise, okay, I have to save this class, otherwise, I left. Okay. So now, if I will, subclass is there. Now, if I will create an object of the subclass, then what happened? If I will create a class of the subclass and I'll call the t.m2, so which method will be executed? Which method will be executed? Here, this concept is called overriding concept. Overriding. Okay, this concept is called overriding, means non-static method. Redefining superclass non-static method in the subclass with same prototype. Okay, redefining non-static method, always non-static method in the super class. In the super class, redefining non-static method in the subclass, same method, non-static method will be defined in the subclass with same prototype. This concept is called method overriding. But which method will be executed? So it depends upon which type of class object you are created. Okay, now I have created this subclass type of an object, so that's why it will subclass type of an object will be executed, means overriding concept is executing which type of the object class you are created. Okay, now I have created subclass type of an object. I've created subtype of an object. So now the subtype of the method will be executed. You can say subtype, you know, M2 subclass is executed. If you will create this again, I am holding this. This is the superclass type and I am creating the object of subtype. So which method will be executed? Okay, which method will be executed? Can you give the answer? Can you give me the answer? Which method will be executed now? Anyone can give the answer? Which method will be executed? Which one? Superclass. No. You can see I have created the object of subclass only, right? But the type is only superclass. It not depend upon this type. It always depend upon which object is created. So I have created the subclass object. So only subclass is executed only. Understood, right? So it depend upon which type of object is created. Understood? So it is subclass type. I will come in this overriding concept again. Okay. So this is the example of overriding. So same thing I had discussed here. If superclass reference variable hold subclass object, then on the variable we can call only overridden method of superclass in subclass, and those methods which are available in the superclass, but we cannot call the specified method of the subclass. So now these are the different examples, and now I will come in this. Actually, I think this code is not working in this edit class. Let's see. Okay. So just I will discuss this, what I am doing here. I think just I'll check it is working or not. Actually, my object class is not working. I have to check it, okay? Just I am able to compile or not. What is the object class? What is the object class? In the last session I had discussed, object class is the supermost class, right? Object class is the supermost class in the CoreJava. Okay. Yeah, good. Okay, so you guys know. Okay, so just I'll try to do that because sometime it is not working. Oh my god, someone is fighting here. Okay. So just I'll try. If I'm not able to do, then now this is my problem in my system, okay? So without extending, by default object class is there, okay? So you can see here we have a one class A and we have a one method M1. Again, these class are called sibling class, right? I did not extend this. So we have a M1 and M2 method. Now what we are doing here, this object class, we are holding on this. Okay, this object is class type of A, right? This is class type of A. Now if you will call this method M1 method, so where is M1 method? This A type, right? This A type. But you can tell, you can see here the type is different. The type is object type reference variable. If you will call this method, then what will happen? We are getting cannot find the symbol. Okay. My question is, why we are getting cannot find the symbol? Actually, what will happen if you are holding the object of the subclass, superclass, this is the superclass. If you holding the object of the superclass, this is the A class, not a super, because I am not using here extend. This is the A class. So what will happen? The compiler or JVM will find which type of reference variable. You can see here I have given the object type of the reference variable, but this method is present in inside the A class. So JVM is not able to identify. Understood? I am not using here extend keyword, don't confuse. In the previous session I have used this extend keyword, right? But here I am not using, this is the sibling classes. Here by default this object class will come because of my system issue. This I have given this explicitly. Okay, so main what will happen, the JVM or compiler is not able to find this method, right? Sorry, this type is not able to find, okay? Because I am not using extend keyword, there is no relation between this A and this object class, this reference variable. So that's why we are able to get this. Now we have a solution of this. Okay, to solve this problem, we have to use casting. Now what we I did here, this A1 reference type variable, I have converted into A-type. Now this A1 reference variable is converted into A-type. Now if you will call this method, now we are able to execute this. So what I did here, this is called conversion. This object type of reference variable, I have converted into a type of the class by using this casting. Okay, this opening and closing braces. I will give you theory also in the coming classes. So now the compiler and JVM is able to understand this a type, because we are not using this inheritance concept, right? So there is no relation we are getting. Now we are able to compile this and we are able to run this. Understood, right? This conversion, are you able to understand? Because this is the very important concept. I will come in the casting, upcasting and downcasting after this example. Okay, so now I am going to stop your class today. Do you have any